Good evening, everybody. I hope you're out there. I hope you've tuned in. I am back. It is the 21st. It's the 22nd day of September 2017. It is 2:11 a.m. and this is Brian live from San Antonio, Texas. I am going to talk. We are going to listen to a broadcast that was done way back, or at least in the past before I came along, talking Trek Wars 931, a funny podcast presents. I hope you guys enjoy. If you haven't heard it, maybe you will. I've never heard it. But anyway, top stories tonight are the earthquake in Mexico. More than 273 are dead. Death toll is expected to rise. They are still currently sifting through rubble and debris and all that. It could be a while. If you are not hurt, please head for safety if you can. If you cannot, please make sure you let first responders and rescuers know where you're at so they can rescue you. Help is coming. Help is there. Just be patient. I know it's hard, but be patient. This has been a very traumatic month with storms and now the earthquake. If you were out there and you're ravaged by a storm or you're destroyed, please know that help is there, help is on the way. FEMA and the Red Cross will help. They're doing the best they can. You just have to be patient. They're spread thin. They're coming from other states. Again, our thoughts and prayers are with you here at Speaker Studio and for my family and for Diane and her family. Actually, we're all family together, just different states right now. That plans to change. By the way, say hi to Diane. She's in Missouri helping her mom, but she is going to co-host the show as soon as we figure out how to do it both ways. Either way, it's going to be a tag team event. Coming up on later broadcasts, we'll have a Spanish-English broadcast, and see how that goes. If you have something you want to talk about, something you want to hear, feel free to let me know at bdhammond45@gmail.com or at 210-708-8701 at any time. This podcast is open to any and all ideas. You're tuning in live. You can tune us in at speakerstudio.com/talkingtrekwars931, a funny podcast. .com. You can catch me on demand, Twitter, iHeartRadio, or on my Facebook page, which is Brian Hammond at Facebook.com. It's live, you can get it. You know how to pick it up there. But anyway, there's many ways to catch it. If you can't do it now, you can catch me on demand, download it, listen to it later. I must warn you, I'm unaware of any explicit language that you may or may not have your young ones hear, or maybe you don't like those words. Again, I do not know. I've never heard the broadcast. But if there is offensive language, I do apologize ahead of time. Please know that. I'm not out to offend anybody. If there are children or you have young children, you might have them step out of the room. Of course, that is up to you. Okay? But let's get right to it. It's a long one. Try to do some of it. If not, we'll pick it up tomorrow. Hopefully earlier. I do thank you for joining us. And I hope you enjoy the rest of this broadcast.
One. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of A Funny Podcast Presents Talk to Trek Wars. It's Berg here. It is Sunday, September 3rd. Tomorrow is Labor Day when this should go out. And I have sitting with me the fantastic, fantabulous duo of the Wins, the return of the Wins, Mandy and Sean.
High five.
No.
No. Oh.
Hey. Slip down the line.
There you go. You. We, I'm sorry. I come from a locker room bro culture, and you're not allowed to turn down a high five.
He always turns down my high fives. That's why I did it.
Which is why I was trying to be nice. Like, as a brother, I turned down so many high fives in the last 2 weeks, and I just couldn't get one from my wife.
Nope.
Turned down a high five?
Oh, turned down
all my high fives.
My buddy Gene and I will go to concerts, and sometimes when we're walking through the venue, we'll just see random people like, "What up, dude?" Just high-fiving random people, and when somebody puts it out, like, you really want to get the Chris, like if somebody puts a high five up to me, I'm going all in.
Give a high five to a stranger, like,
okay, yeah, all right. So we're here. We got some fun topics, but first, let's get an update. Sean, how are things going? What is happening with your podcast? How's your album?
Oh, too many questions. Okay, so the podcast is actually doing pretty well. We took a break for a while, only because I've been pretty busy. But we returned last week with special guest Matt Weiss, returned episode. So lead that, and that's the episode that will air leading into Rose City Comic Con, where we will be doing a live show Saturday, 1:30 at Hall H, I believe. Special guests to be announced.
TBD.
To be guessed. I mean, well, I can tell you one, because I'm allowed to tell you one, and one of them is E. Ringo Gustavo. So that's all you get. As far as the music, the Praetorians album, I gotta say, I know this is gonna sound bad, it's doing tremendous. Like, we've had such success that, like, not that I didn't expect it, but I didn't expect it to be this great. To the point where we were able to take some of our album sales money and put it towards charity a couple times, actually. And the reason that was Keelan's idea, so credit to Keelan for, you know, always thinking, like, what we can do for the community, not just, like, gain money from, like, you know, hip-hop, but the video has over 7,500 views now, and yeah, the album sales are great, and we did a show at Dante's on the 24th that was pretty cool, so yeah.
When is Desmond coming out so we can get the
DeMond.
DeMond. Okay. When is DeMond coming out so we can get the full show, and then that should be the whole...
You know, we actually just talked to him about that recently. We want to fly him back out and do, like, a big show. Either that or maybe we'll go to Scotland and do a show there. So, get some love from the hometown, or that's where he still lives. So,
yeah.
It's coming together, I promise you. TBD.
Well, we'll keep you all updated. Okay, we got a wealth of things to get into. Shall we do the Defenders first, and we'll circle back to the Star Wars stuff? Or do you want to do the Star Wars stuff first?
Let's do the Star Wars stuff first, because there's a lot.
Okay. All right. Here's where you're going to... got to get the mouth ready, because it's going to dry out here as I talk about this.
I didn't even know about some of these.
Okay. Now, The Hollywood Reporter, about 2 weeks ago, reported that Stephen Daldry, who directed Billy Elliot, The Hours, Oscar-nominated, who works on a show now called The Crown, he's an executive producer and writer for that, has been approached to do an Obi-Wan Kenobi standalone film, which is not... Everybody always assumed they were going to do an Obi-Wan movie. Now, this isn't confirmed from Lucasfilm, but Lucasfilm never really confirms these things. They just tend to happen in The Hollywood Reporter or Variety or any one of the trades comes out. You can generally bank on the information. Now, maybe they might be negotiating for more money or whatnot. But within the article, they also talked about the Lucasfilm's ideas, quote-unquote, for a Boba Fett spinoff, which has a history. We'll go into that in a minute. A young Yoda movie and a Jabba the Hutt movie. Now, before I answer those two things, because I have some strong feelings about those.
I know you do.
The Boba Fett film was originally supposed to be out before the Han Solo film. It was supposed to follow Rogue One with director Josh Trank, who did Chronicle, and the abysmal failure that was The Fantastic Four, regardless of their great cast.
I'm respectful.
Touche. And he was in development with Simon Kinberg, who works for Lucasfilm. He's also known for his producing and writing of the current X-Men movies. And he also was involved in Fantastic Four. They butted heads. He said he's got to go. Trank showed up allegedly intoxicated and mildly crazy. And they said, okay, step. They even had a trailer for the movie. They had a digital short trailer like they did for Rogue One that was supposed to premiere at Star Wars Celebration in Anaheim in 2015. So that got shelved. So everybody knows that there's eventually a Boba Fett movie coming on, and they've actually talked about it being more of a bounty hunters movie to incorporate all of them, so it's kind of like a rogues gallery type.
Right.
Type idea, but you also can't discount that there's a Han Solo movie coming out that spans 6 years. Boba Fett and Jabba the Hutt and should or will be in that movie at some point in some way or another, whether they're tertiary or they have a minor supporting role, whatever. Now, I'm gonna. Do you guys have any comment before I start laying into the young Yoda idea?
Yeah, before.
Okay, you, like, yeah, before let's
just the fact that I do hate the fact that we are getting the Solo movie before any of those, which is like we just got enough of him.
Yeah.
Upon Solo. We got enough of him in the last movie, but like
that
story is important and needs to be told sooner rather than later, man.
Yeah,
there's, like you said, there's so much that character that we've had limited access to. He's important, way more important.
And you think you would answer some people's criticism of Boba Fett that he never does anything in the movies. He does one thing, that's right. It. Then he gets knocked into a Sarlacc pit. That's it. But he's still got so much fan love. Why not mine that territory?
Why not only mine that territory, but make the smart business decision to make a ton of money?
Well, you would think.
Are they thinking of doing more?
That's not been said. Everybody's hoping a post-Return of the Jedi, him getting out of the Sarlacc pit movie. And that's what I'm thinking that they should do. But there's no saying that they will, because they're right now... Anything after the Battle of Jakku is off-limits.
Oh, that's right.
Everything from Battle of Jakku up to the book Bloodline by Claudia Gray, that 20-year span, untouchable. Untouchable because... And it makes a little bit of sense because they don't want to put anything in concrete while they're still developing the new trilogy because they are taking each film as it is. They don't have an overall... plan for how the characters are supposed to end up by the time we get to episode 9. It's J.J. Abrams and Lawrence Kasdan wrote a script, and alright, I'm leaving Rey on the cliff with Luke Skywalker. Like, oh yeah, well, what happened next to him? I don't know. That's up for Rian Johnson to do. So you'd think, but there were unused scripts from the Clone Wars where Boba Fett was supposed to face off with Cad Bane. Well, my feeling is why not, with the Obi-Wan Kenobi movie, do a good, the bad, and the ugly with Obi-Wan, Boba Fett, and Cad Bane, and do a Western set, and then you have Joel Egerton come back as Owen Lars, and you have the threat, and something has to go down, and then you can also, because you're on Tatooine, you can have Jabba the Hutt there, too, in the background.
Because, I mean, he's the biggest gangster.
And he's also the biggest ugly there is in that galaxy.
He's not the most attractive alien, that's for sure.
It's funny that you should make that correlation, because when you were talking about how they were going to do like a Fett movie and have all the bounty hunters, I instantly thought of like some sort of like Magnificent Seven.
Zack Snyder, when they were first pitching spinoffs and directors before any directors was hired, when Lucasfilm was first bought by Disney, Zack Snyder said he wanted to do a Seven Samurai with Jedi film. I know, any other director but Zack Snyder. Okay, cool, let's do it.
The whole Star Wars trope feels like it is blending of Eastern Western. You know, you have the Jedi, which are the samurai, and you have like the Han Solo, which are the outlaws, Wild West.
Yeah.
You know, we already know that sci-fi westerns work. So it definitely would.
You would think we'd get smart. My question becomes, and we can tie it into the Yoda Jabba thing. Is Lucasfilm unwilling to take risks? Are they playing it safe? Because the fact is, everything we're getting is set between or around the OT, primarily between episodes 3 and 4, more closer to 4. And it's all existing characters. The only one that I think was a risk was Rogue One, and they had to...